Hi guys, I'm Nihal. I'm 8 years old, and today I'll be showing you on how to reset. Not on how to reset. How to create a virtual machine in Azure, okay? Or Azure. I'll use the word Azure for now. Okay, so I'll show you my presentation first. So this is on what is Microsoft Azure. First, you need to know what it is. If there are any mistakes, just let me know in the comments, or it's excuse me, so okay, I'll present. Okay. What is Microsoft Azure? By Nihal K. What is a cloud? Before you learn anything on Azure, first you need to know what a cloud is. Cloud computing is when you do something on the cloud and the process is happening somewhere else. Of course, you don't need to know where the process is happening. Let's say a VM. If you open VirtualBox or VMware, and it's using the host's hardware. But if it's on a cloud, if the VM is on the cloud, the VM is not using the host's hardware. Instead, it's using a data center server's hardware. Like if the cloud is like from a data center, like Microsoft data center, the VM which you create is actually a data center server. Instead, it's using a data center server's hardware. Different types of clouds are IaaS, Infrastructure as a Service, PaaS, Platform as a Service, SaaS, Software as a Service, MBaaS, Mobile Backend as a Service, and FaaS, Function as a Service. Azure is a data storage service that allows you to create VMs. You can create them in your web browser, but not connect to them in your web browser. Sorry. SQL databases, resource groups, and more. Azure facts. Microsoft Azure was the cloud system developed by Microsoft in February 1st, 2010. I think you all know Microsoft Azure is already a cloud. But if you do not know, was it February 1st, 2010? Yeah, I think not many people know that. Azure is a type of cloud. The type of cloud Azure is PaaS, Platform as a Service. Azure offers 600 services. It's called Azure because of the color of a cloud, and Azure is a cloud. Azure can only create Windows VMs and Linux VMs. Azure's logo looks like a blue A. You can see its logo later. You don't need to change the settings of Azure. You don't need SSMS to create databases. You can use SQL databases and you can create SQL databases in Azure. Oh, that's it. Wait, how do you exit this? Okay, so that's my presentation. It only has 3 slides. And that's not many facts. You can always look up facts on Google. Okay, so first that you'll need to log into Azure. It's portal.and log into Azure and create an account. We'll send the steps to create an account. Okay, I have a lot of credit left. They'll give you 200% credit. We'll talk about more about subscriptions later. You go to Virtual Machine Services and add in Virtual Machine. The arrow next to add. You click on that. Click on this over here, the small arrow. And first, you need to know what a subscription is. A subscription is like there are 2 subscriptions. One is and I forgot to tell you a cloud is always pay as you go. I think Azure gives you 200 free credit as your first time, but just like how you use electricity, like when you use electricity, as you're using electricity, you're paying pay as you go. Like you pay as you're using. So Azure gives 200 free credit. In a subscription, my subscription has 200% free credit. No, actually it's 900, no, not 900, 192% credit left. So a subscription is just like a subscription, like when you subscribe to YouTube channels, like it's a subscription. And a resource group, like a resource group is as simple as a container that holds related resources, like maybe a disk and a VM, or maybe like a click create new link over here and put any name for it. I heard this name when I was trying to learn Azure, so I'm just gonna use it. And next is the virtual machine name. The virtual machine name is actually important if you're gonna use Windows, the Microsoft Remote Desktop. No, not remote desktop. Remote desktop connection manager. The name is important because you won't be able to connect if you do not know the name. And you'll need to know the IP address if you're going to use this. Because you get it any name from anywhere. Get a name from anywhere. I'm gonna just going to put Windows 2016 OS. For some reason, I always want to use Windows Server 2016 as an Azure VM. Okay, and region, it can be any region, this does not matter, it's just like a region. And leave these two at default. This, choose any image, but this, today we're gonna do it on Windows, since if you're using an Ubuntu, if you're using Ubuntu over here, yeah, if you're using Ubuntu, you wanna use, PuTTY, PuTTY is located in program files, it's not there right now. Yeah, but you'll need PuTTY and make sure it's not red around here. So you want to choose a different one. And next is a username. Whenever I put a username, it's just going to say, when I try to connect, it's going to say my password is wrong. But, and I'm going to put, okay, good. And I should copy this. And I should paste it over here. Okay, so next I'm gonna use my host's password for this one. Oh, you cannot copy passwords, so I might need to type. It's way. Yeah, I think it's 12345. This is not my host's password. It's a way different password. Okay, that's good and that's good. Let me go back to Notepad and good. And if you for any type of virtual machine, check all of these. And if you're using Windows RDP is required, if yours is Ubuntu or Linux or Red Hat, your SSH is required because you want to be able to connect to it, since Azure does not offer anything to connect to it except Bastion, I think. I don't know how to pronounce it. If I'm pronouncing it wrong, sorry. So disks and create and attach a new disk. And enable share disk, yes. Choose the max choice as 504 and OK. And you can also attach an existing disk. Yeah, right now there's no available. And you can also edit the disk, and it went back to no. It does not want me to do that. So let me change this back to 5. This is, and I think you can go to networking. Check all of these. We'll do that by default. If you did not do that, check all of these. And next you can skip to advanced. Select an extension to install. And you see, we have all of these. We have the NVIDIA thing over here. I think NVIDIA, you will have the NVIDIA control panel in your Windows CPL. You can load more extensions for your virtual machine. Datadog agent. What is Datadog? This looks interesting. Let me choose it. Okay, I don't know what Datadog is, that's not okay. But stay at networking if you don't want any extensions, and hit review and create. Actually, it won't create, it would validate. And it says validation passed, so that's good. What? You can hit create. Deployment is empty. I'll come back after it finished deploying, okay? Also, I forgot to tell you, the difference between virtual machine scale sets and virtual machines is that a virtual machine scale set is like, it creates virtual machines whenever it needs to, the system. So, that's a virtual machine scale set. But if it's a normal virtual machine, it won't do that. And actually, virtual machine scale sets, you can do the exact same process, but they're a little different thing, so we're not going to do it today. Oh, it finished deploying. Let me go back. Click on create, go to resource, click it, you can pick it over here, or you can pick it in the middle. And now you see all of these. This looks confusing, but the first way is you can copy the IP address and paste it into RDP and connect and do whatever it does. But it's also another way, and just because I said we'll do the second way, the other way. And you connect over here and RDP. And these are the IP address, and this is the port number. You don't want to change the port number, and I don't know who'd want to connect to these by SSH. Okay, so you see the putties over here, so we can check all of these telnet. I think this is right. I think, yeah. You can change the art. You can look at these things. If you choose the wrong port, it won't connect. Raw. If you want to connect to Windows machines, you can use raw. And let me do. You can wait. I'm just gonna try something around here. Wait. You don't do it. If people who want to follow, you can do it. And let's try 3389. Oh, it's just not doing anything. Yeah, but you want to go back to connect for the people who tried it and hit download RDP file. And you'll see this RDP file over here. Click on it. If yours is Internet Explorer, it'll appear in the middle. Yours is Firefox, it'll appear here. If it's Microsoft Edge or Google, like mine is, it will be over here, like in the middle. And you'll see a wide window over here. Click connect. And if you're gonna keep on connecting to this computer, check this. And it will ask you for the password, the username. So, the username right now, get it from here. I know the username was Windows 2000. Was it this? I think it was this. This was, the username. And the password, I think, was this. And Control V. And remember me if you're gonna connect to this virtual machine often. And you'll get the same window before the authentication, so except this is a little taller. And we'll configure the remote session. And yeah, if it successfully did the thing, I think this weak connection. Actually, as you can see, this is 15 minutes over here. It's 15 minutes. I'm sorry, guys, for 15 minutes. And yes, if you may get a sidebar. If this is Windows 7 and lower, I don't even know if Azure offers Windows 7, but you'll want to check S in the small sidebar over here. And you can see we have successfully connected to Microsoft Windows. This is Windows 2016, and if we go to Control Panel, and you see we have a control panel window over here. And now if we go to system and security and system, and as you can see, this is the exact same name we entered in at. And you see we have and right now this Windows does not look like it's activated or not. Yeah, so that's it for today, guys, and I'll see you next time, okay? Bye!